subscribe to my YouTube channel and click the bell icon for the latest film interviews, features, and recommendations on the movies that matter. If one had to point to a common thread that links the best performances by male actors this year, it would be the pursuit of truth in their chosen parts.
Action!
The characters they played couldn't be more dissimilar, yet each was authentic to his respective world, imbued with the empathy or passion or complexity invested by the artist playing him.
We love dancing!
In Ludo, Rajkumar Rao brought genuine sweetness and charming humor to the role of a besotted romantic whose devotion to a girl in his school remains unwavering even after she's married and has a child. Jaideep Alawat masterfully slipped into the skin of an undervalued but sincere police officer who becomes desperate to prove his potential when he's tasked with his career's most important case in Patal Lok.
Jain sir.
In Gunjan Saxena, the Kargil girl, Pankaj Tripathi relied on his innate kindness and warmth and his propensity for minimalism to play a supportive father who is the wind beneath his daughter's wings.
Plane ladka uda hai ya ladki, dono ko pilot hi bolte hain.
In the second season of Mirzapur, Divyendu Sharma sought out the emotional truth buried within the seemingly dark, cold heart of a villain that we'd come to despise, humanizing him in the process. Playing a middle-class fellow who chances upon unexpected wealth in Loot Case, Kunal Khemu dialed up the humor to create a winning portrait of an everyman who's desperate to protect his fortune from multiple threats.
हम लोग का ना खाली ड्यूटी बदलता है, किस्मत कभी नहीं बदलती।
Nawazuddin Siddiqui approached his role as a shrewd, determined manipulator in Serious Men with a blend of cheekiness and smarts, creating a character that is ultimately both desperate and fascinating.
क्या बोला था? क्या बताएगा दुनिया को कि मैंने फ्रॉड किया है?
In Tanaji, playing a sadistic general to the Mughal emperor, Saif Ali Khan brought delicious flamboyance and theatrics, giving us an irresistible villain who commanded the screen.
Tu jaan de sakta hai, main jaan le sakta hu.
And in Scam 1992, Pratik Gandhi went beyond the vilifying headlines to deliver an empathetic humanist portrait of a man whose insatiable ambition turned him into the country's biggest white-collar criminal.
Initially, it was called the stock scam. Brokers didn't like it, so they called it the bank scam.
The eight extraordinary actors assembled virtually to talk about their learnings from this unusual year, to weigh in on why they love what they do, how they approach laughing, crying, and dying on screen. And they also spoke about the scene they were most looking forward to shooting when they read the script. This is The A-List. Welcome to the Actors Roundtable 2020. Gentlemen, welcome. You know, I look at this screen today and it's just so amazing to see all of you talented people, you know, on this screen at one go in one place, really. You know, I've started every roundtable this season by saying thank you. And let me tell you why. This has been a strange, uncertain year. It's been a hard year for so many of us. And one of the things that really helped us to get through this year was the work that you put out, the entertainment that you gave us, the art that you put out, those incredible performances, the great shows, the really wonderful films that you made. So first of all, thank you for bringing some joy in an otherwise bleak, dark year. I want to start by asking you, you know, everyone has had a chance to pause and to reflect this year. Sabko mauka mila hai sochne ka, gaur karne ka about our lives. I want to ask you, during this time, did you find that you were reminded just how much you love what you do and really what your art means to you? or were you struck by how insignificant we are and what we do in the larger scheme of things?
Definitely, I missed being on a film set. But luckily, you know, that's the benefit of being in a relationship with an actress, with an actor. And Patulekha and me, we chatted a lot about, we were watching a lot of content, we were consuming a lot of series and fiction films and non-fiction things. And we were talking about that. And we were doing online acting workshops through different websites. And she was preparing for her series and I was preparing for my films. So I didn't really miss it that much. But of course, the fun of being in front of the camera, being on a film set, that's a different kind of high. So I definitely missed that. And I realized that how much I love doing what I do. But also at your second part of your question is, yeah, I think we all are really insignificant. Nobody, doesn't matter. You're an actor or whatever you do. I think when it comes to nature, Mother Nature, we all are just a very, very tiny part of the whole system. Nothing more than that.
Namaste.
आई थिंक जैसे ऑफकोर्स हम लोग करते हैं काम वाम तो करते रहते हैं तो एक मुझे स्पेशली जरूरत थी कि एक सैचुरेशन पॉइंट भी आ रहा था थोड़ा गैप की भी जरूरत थी बट इस तरीके से मिलेगा वो मैं अंदाजे में नहीं था कि भाई पैंडेमिक के तौर पर और इस तरह का हमें चीजें मिलेंगी बट द थिंग इज कि लोगों को बहुत मिस किया इस दौरान यू नो कि फिल्म सेट के अलावा जो फिल्म सेट पे जो दूसरे लोग होते हैं जो एक माहौल होता है वो मिस किया और लोग जो होते हैं वो ऑफकोर्स हम लोग एक साथ रहने वाली कम्युनिटी हैं जो डेफिनेटली अगर अलग अलग अपने घर पे बंद हो जाएंगे तो डेफिनेटली लोगों को बहुत मिस करेंगे और ये भी इस दौरान ये भी एहसास हुआ इस बात का कि बहुत कम चीज़ों में काम चलाया जा सकता है और जिस तरीके से हम लोग भाग रहे थे मेटलिस्टिक चीज़ों पर या कि वो बेमानी लगने लगी थी एक टाइम पे पेंडेमिक के टाइम पे कि यार ठीक है ये सब तो होता रहेगा लेकिन एक्चुअली हमें शायद इसलिए पॉज मिला इस जनरेशन को इस टाइम को इस इरा को ये वक्त मिला ताकि हम फिर से सोच सकें कि हम कौन सी दिशा में जा रहे हैं और कौन सी दिशा में हमें जाना चाहिए आई थिंक इस तरह के इंट्रोस्पेक्शंस बहुत हुए
यू नो राजीव आई ऑनेस्टली फील दैट यू नो एवरी नाउ एंड देन ऑन ऑल योर गैजेट्स यू गेट अ सॉफ्टवेयर अपडेट एंड देन यू हैव टू रीबूट योर फोन एंड इट टेक्स अ व्हाइल टू डू दैट आई थिंक फॉर अस वी वुड नेवर हैव डन दैट अदरवाइज बट इफ वी वर जस्ट पुट इनटू दिस पोजीशन वेयर वी वर फोर्स्ड टू डू दैट And while we could, you know, worry about what is going to happen with work and the other things, I think what we, like Nawaz Bhai also said, we started to respect, value and cherish the little things that we actually on a day-to-day basis did not, you know, care for much. I'm saying as simple as the freedom. Ki I still have the choice to go out whenever I want, to whatever restaurant I want, to meet whoever I want, whether I use it or not. But now the choice was taken away. So even things like that, like I think after 2 months or 3 months of lockdown, the first time you met your parents or your family, that meant a lot. And I think creativity also kind of came out, whether it was writing or actors, you know, we saw so much content, which we did not have a chance to watch otherwise. We got to learn so much what is happening in the world. So I think it was that software update that was required. I don't hope for many more such software updates to happen in the future. But I mean, we have to take the positives away from what we did.
So I guess I had the best of family time in the worst of the conditions. Well, I never thought that I'll get such a family time in this pandemic situation. And in my entire family, including me, we had gone through this corona in July. So 1.5 months actually went into that fight with corona. And as Nawaz sir also said, as these guys also said, that this is what it is. Basics pe hi dhyan gaya. Because ghadi... बहुत प्यारी थी नई घड़ी लेनी है नए शूज लेने हैं उस पर बहुत ध्यान जाता था पहले जब ये लॉकडाउन चालू हुआ तब पहला ध्यान एक ही चीज पे जाता था कि सब्जी कहाँ से आएगी और दूध कौन लेके जाएगा तो इतना बैक टू बेसिक हो गया था कि पूरी मतलब चीज को देखने का नजरिया ही बदल गया एंड एज फार एज दिस इंडस्ट्री इज कंसर्न वी एज एन एक्टर इज कंसर्न आई गेस एवरीबडी सेड दैट अत्यावश्यक सेवाएं तो शायद इसका जिक्र कभी अत्यावश्यक सेवाओं में हुआ नहीं पर शायद इसी चीज ने इसी इंडस्ट्री ने लोगों को घर पे स्क्रीन के सामने बिठाए रखा उसी की वजह से शायद बहुत कुछ कंट्रोल में भी हुआ सो इट्स अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग सिचुएशन टू ऑब्जर्व
सर
यू नो ऑनेस्टली यू नो आई डिडंट फाइंड एनीथिंग वेरी डिफरेंट इन माय लाइफ आई मीन ऑफ कोर्स इट वाज अ रियली फ्राइटनिंग टाइम व्हेन वी थॉट मेबी फूड विल रन आउट और एवरीवन वाज बाइंग ऑल द stuff from the shops, you know, thinking it was going to be like a war or blackout or I don't know what. So that was a bit worrying, maybe run out of water, you know. But I mean, I've always felt this way. I've always loved, I mean, not always, but for a long time, I've loved what I do. I understand my place in this world. I understand my life. I understand the importance of what we do and the insignificance of it all, ultimately. So no change, really, that the lockdown has brought to my table, that I've suddenly had this thunderstroke or, you know, lightning thing that, oh my God, life is meaningless. Or, you know, or the idea, I mean, you stand on top of a mountain, you feel you're insignificant, obviously. But at the same time, the human being is capable of defeating the microbe. At the same time, you can put a rocket on the moon. At the same time, you can increase lifespan by about 20,000. I mean, you know, 10 times since 1700 by being a human being. So we are not insignificant in any way, actually. You know, in fact, we're all there is. So as far as acting goes, I mean, I got in a bit of trouble. I thought someone didn't understand my comment when I said, it's not unlike working in the front lines. Obviously, health workers are more important and more noble because they are risking their lives to save people, but the mental health of a society is also important. And actors who have to go out and work in an environment which is air-conditioned and with 200 people, you can't wear a mask. It's slightly high risk, I would have thought. So we have gone out, a lot of us, and worked. We've supported the economy when we've had to. We've supported, and we stayed home when we had to. So I'm sorry, I won't be able to say that there was some great learning from this.
Sure. Pankaj ji?
बहुत अच्छी बातें सुनने को मिल रही है इसमें, मैं क्या राय दूं, मेरे लिए यही लर्निंग है आज सबकी जो सुन रहा हूं। करेक्ट, मैं दोनों से सहमत हूं। जब नवाज सर बोल रहे थे और कुणाल बोल रहे थे रिबूट की बात, यार आज तो मुझे लगा बहुत कमाल की बात कर रहे हैं। जब सैफ सर ने बोला कि कुछ कमाल नहीं हुआ, मुझे लगा ये भी कमाल की बात कर रहे हैं। तो प्रतीक, सबकी बातों से मैं सहमत हूं और थोड़ा थोड़ा सब हुआ है मेरे साथ भी ऐसा ही कुछ।
दिवेंदु?
Yeah, it's actually, to be honest, I didn't miss work at all. I realized the fact that, yes, I'm a lazy being, and the only good part was I was very, very comfortable with myself, you know, not working, sitting at home, then, you know, went back to reading, watching stuff, you know, discover cooking. Yes, I understand that, you know, we are the fortunate ones that we have the means to, you know, enjoy that. We enjoyed those 6, 7, 8 months, that it came sort of a holiday, sort of a retreat, sort of a thing for us. But yeah, at the same time, it was very unfortunate for a lot of people. But honestly saying it, I was very happy not working, not meeting too many people. Yeah, it was just, it was at peace, everyone. You know, it was actually one of those HBO films you watch on a Sunday afternoon where there is a virus outside, you can't go outside, everyone is talking in a hush-hush tone. Dheere bolo, bahar koi hai, kuch ho jayega, dunia khatam hone wali hai. But there was certain kind of a peace about, you know, the whole thing. So, it didn't affect me, that it's not, that I'm not getting too affected by it. But yeah, you can't lie to yourself that if you're okay with it, you're okay with it. And I was okay with it.
Okay. Jadeep?
सर कुछ बचा नहीं है बाकी कहने को, सबने बोली दी है सारी बातें। बट मैं, मुझे 97 में हरियाणा में बाढ़ आई थी, हम नए स्कूल से पास आउट हुए थे और कुछ 1.5 महीने के लिए मेरे गांव के आसपास के सारे गांव डूब गए थे और सिर्फ हमारा ही गांव ऐसा था जो बाहर नहीं निकला था अपने गाँव से, क्योंकि पानी घरों के अंदर नहीं घुसा था, बाकी आसपास के 10-15 गाँव सड़क पे थे। तो मुझे वो टाइम याद आया जब 1.5-2 महीने के आसपास लाइट नहीं थी और पूरा गांव हाईवे था, नेशनल हाईवे नंबर 10 है हमारा हरियाणा में, वहां उस रोड पे सोता था क्योंकि घरों में सो नहीं सकते, मच्छर बहुत हैं, गर्मियों के दिन थे। तो सडनली आपको ऐसा लगता है कि आप बॉम्बे शहर में, सडनली जब आपको लगता है कि आप बहुत अकेले हो और आप सिर्फ काम के लिए लोगों से मिलते, बहुत कम दोस्त होते हैं, फिर भी हम कुछ लकी लोग हैं कि मेरे FTI के बैचमेट्स हैं या कुछ और दोस्त हैं। बट उस टाइम पे आपको बाहर सड़क पे चलने वाला शायद कोई आदमी जो एकदम अननोन है आपसे, उससे भी एक बार पूछने का मन करता है, भाई चाय दूध की है या सिगरेट है तेरे पास, कुछ भी, कोई भी ऐसी चीज जो तेरी बेसिक नीड हो ना, सडनली कम्युनिटी बड़ी हो जाती है। आपको लगने लगता है हर आदमी कहीं भी कोई भी जो है फेसबुक पे या कहीं कोई दिख रहा है तो मुझे लगा कि लोग अपने अंदर जाने के बजाय बाहर निकलने की कोशिश की लोगों ने, जो कि शायद भागदौड़ जब सब बाहर है तब शायद एक दूसरे को उतना क्लोजली ऑब्जर्व नहीं करते हैं, लेकिन इस दौरान इस पेंडेमिक में इतनी सारी खबरें सुनी कि लोग एक दूसरे की हेल्प कर रहे हैं, वो देख के आदमी को लगता है कि जब आपको एक्चुअली जरूरत पड़ेगी कोई ना कोई खड़ा होगा आपके साथ, वो मुझे लगा कि थोड़ी सी अच्छी फीलिंग थी, सिस्टम शायद ना हो लेकिन आदि इंसान खड़े होंगे आपके साथ.
चलिए फिल्मों के बारे में बात करते हैं. ईच ऑफ यू डज कॉम्प्लेक्स सीन्स एंड कॉम्प्लेक्स इमोशंस सो वेल दैट इट अपीयर्स एफर्टलेस ऑन स्क्रीन. आई हैव हर्ड एक्टर्स से दैट समटाइम्स इट्स द सीमिंगली सिंपल स्टफ दैट इज हार्डर टू डू. I want to ask each of you, is it harder to laugh on screen or to cry on screen? Not to make others laugh or cry, but to actually be the person that is laughing or crying.
Well, I find it easier to laugh, mostly, unless I'm in touch with the side. I'm just a little emotionally blocked, yeah, when it comes to... I find my weakness is in, in some of the tearful stuff. A part of me is blocked in that area. I need to work on that. So I find it much easier to laugh.
I think for me, anything to do convincingly, anything to do truthfully, actually, to find that truth in your performance, it can be a very simple scene of just your reaction shot. We're just listening to your co-actor. I think everything is, it comes for me, comes down to how much you're present in that moment. It can be a laughing scene. It can be a crying scene. If I'm not there in that moment, if I'm doing it for a reason that, you know, let me do it this way because, you know, that way maybe audience will laugh. And that's not honest for me. That's like, I'm not doing it for myself. For me, I have to do it for myself first. Like, and if I'm not like, I'm cut up there in that moment, then there's no point doing it. So for me, it doesn't matter what the scene is. If I'm not there in that moment, it can be anything. It doesn't work.
I think I've heard.
Isn't the question, is it easier for you to laugh or cry?
Yeah.
What is the, I if think you have it to doesn't choose matter. One?
No,
the question is not, does it matter? Even
no,
for me,
I've never really
matter.
Thought. I've never really thought like that. It's like you like. It's like asking you like batting or bowling. I don't know. I like.
Well,
both.
Of course,
like
you playing. Ask. If you ask Virat Kohli, you'll get an answer.
But I'm not Virat Kohli, na. I like cricket. Like I'm saying, I like cricket. I like playing cricket. I like bowling sometimes. I like batting sometimes.
Okay, so that's a good answer. That's a good answer. He likes both. Depends.
Yeah. I feel that it's tougher for me to. Like laugh wholeheartedly and it's easier to I just feel it's easier to get caught if you're doing that wrong. I mean, in crying you can still get away with a lot of aids, you know, somebody can use glycerin and, you know, get into that, but laughing is one of those things that it's I think it's easier to get caught if you're doing it wrong or if you're bad at it. So I'm definitely more thoughtful if it is me laughing as opposed to crying.
So which do you choose?
I find it tougher to just laugh.
Okay.
Yeah. Same for me. I so agree with Kunal. I mean, it's laughing at times. I see myself on screen. It's like बहुत नकली है. ये तो बहुत नकली तरीके से किया है. ये वो हंसी नहीं है जो मैं हंसता हूँ. लेकिन फिर मुझे कभी-कभी वो बहुत मुश्किल हो जाता है. I mean, हंसना या कोई भी या laughing is it's very very tough, man. I mean, emotion. Yeah. You there is a certain channel you go through it. And you would, most of the time, you would reach there, at least for me. But laughing, and also it's not just laughing in isolation. You have your co-actor. Aur wo agar achha nahi karega, toh it's very difficult to laugh, you know, ki kya baat kahi hai, you know. Ye bahut, so it's very tough. Laughing is, rona bahut asaan hai. अगर ये भी लगे कि तुम बहुत बुरा काम कर रहे हो तभी भी आप रो सकते हो उसी को लेके कि बहुत बुरा सीन जा रहा है मैं रो सकता हूं but yeah, to laugh when it's absolutely not working, it's very difficult.
I think वो लाफ्टर के साथ भी होता है. जैसे एक एक्टर ने मुझसे पूछा है मेरे से हंसना नहीं आता, तो मैंने कहा इसी बात पे हंस ले कि तुझसे हंसना नहीं आता. I think मुझे लगता है राज was correct at that point, क्योंकि जो I think ये दो एक ऐसे इमोशन हैं जो बहुत ही क्लीशेड हैं और सबसे आसान एक्टर के लिए आई थिंक सबसे आसान होता है किसी को हंसाना या खुद पे हंसना या रुलाना या खुद पे रोना, ये सबसे आसान है क्योंकि अगर रोने वाली बात है तो इतना फ्रस्ट्रेशन लोगों की लाइफ में इतना होता है वो पता चले जहाँ 5% रोने की जरूरत है वहाँ 100% रो देता है वो खुद के उसकी जरूरत ही नहीं थी जबकि वो कैरेक्टर वो था ही नहीं. तो मुझे लगता है जैसे राज ने बोला टू बी ऑनेस्ट इन दैट मोमेंट वो बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट होता है. आई थिंक उसके लिए ही स्ट्रगल करता है थ्रू आउट द प्रोसेस में एक्टर. उसके लिए आई थिंक ये एक्टर के लिए सबसे इजी इमोशंस होते हैं और हम इस दोनों इमोशन के अलावा बाकी जितने भी इमोशंस हैं उस पर कभी डिस्कस ही नहीं करते. इफ आई एम इफ आई जस्ट टॉक अबाउट लाइक एक न्यूट्रल सा इमोशन, न्यूट्रल से परफॉर्मेंस में हम वो सबसे टफ टाइम होता है जब आपको न्यूट्रल कोई उसमें कोई इमोशन नहीं है कुछ नहीं. एक बंदा है बहुत ही ड्राई सा बंदा है उसके ऊपर पूरी पिक्चर है. लेकिन हम लोगों की आदत होती है उसमें कुछ या तो कुछ यार कुछ
ड्रामा डालें, मसाला डालो,
ड्रामा डालें, ये डालें. आई थिंक टू बी ऑनेस्ट इन द मोमेंट दैट्स द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग.
बट आल्सो आई थिंक यू नो लाफ्टर इज समथिंग आई हैव एंजॉयड डूइंग इन अ कपल ऑफ सीन्स. इन दिल चाहता है मेनी इयर्स अगो देयर वाज नो सीन. There was something I had to say to Akshay Khanna about a balloon and a lover who enjoys giving balloons. And I just, at that moment, thought, I have a cousin who has a very funny laugh. And he laughs so much that everybody feels like laughing, whoever talks to him, you know. And sometimes he holds his nose, and he, you know, iftikhar, if you know kuna. And he tries not to laugh, and his whole face goes purple. So laughter can be very nuanced. It's like if you're in front of your house, high school principal, and he's bajaing you for something, all of you, and one guy wants to laugh, you know you'll get expelled. So that feeling of not laughing and trying to, so it can be an extremely nuanced, torturous thing. It's not just ha ha ha, obviously, as you guys know, like even crying is so complex and comes from different areas. So a laughter, I did a scene in this Bhoot Police I've just finished where the guy in the front's talking to someone and I'm supposed to laugh in the back. And my laughter is supposed to escalate with each thing he says to a point where I'm having a fit in the background. It's not an easy scene, but it's all about laughing, you know, laughing more till you're stomping, till you're falling down, till you're crying. So laughter it's a thing, you know.
Yeah.
It's an art in itself, I would say.
Pankaji?
नहीं नहीं बहुत बहुत अच्छी अच्छी बात हो गई. अब इसमें क्या
पंकज का जो पूरा रोल हो रहा है वो एक हमारे सीनियर थे, पंकज भी जानते हैं उनको. तो उसके सामने हम जाके बोलते थे यार मैंने आज एक पिक्चर देखी, कमाल की पिक्चर थी. तो उनका था यार अरे हाँ यार कमाल की पिक्चर है, बहुत बढ़िया फिल्म है यार. दूसरा थोड़ी देर के बाद आके बोलता था सर हमने एक फिल्म देखी बहुत ही खराब. हाँ यार वो फिल्म बहुत ही खराब है, बहुत ही खराब है. तो मतलब सबको खुश करना है.
मेरा इसमें एक पॉइंट है ना कि एक्टर इकलौता प्राणी है जो हंसने और रोने दोनों के पैसे पाता है. होता है हंसने के लिए भी रोने के लिए भी. देखिए सर जीवन में हम क्रिएट करते हैं, आर्ट में हम रिक्रिएट करते हैं इमोशन. रिक्रिएट करना बहुत मुश्किल काम है, वो चाहे कुछ भी हो. और हंसी और रोना दो एक्सट्रीम है, वो लाउडर एक्सट्रीम है. ये अस्थाई भाव है. एक भाव होता है संचारी भाव जो आया और चला गया. कि आप हंसी के बीच में आप शक भी कर लिए, हंसते हंसते शक हो गया आपके आदमी पे. तो हंसी के बीच में शक का आना मुश्किल काम है. उस जो संचारी भाव है जो आएगा और जाएगा.
अब इसके लिए भरत मुंडी का नाट्य शास्त्र पढ़ना पड़ेगा.
और पंकज जी हंसने और रोने के पैसे बिगनिंग में नहीं मिलते हैं.
एग्जैक्टली
वो बाद में कमाने पड़ते हैं, बिगनिंग में कोई नहीं देता.
बिगनिंग में तो बस.
But can I just say something?
Yeah.
Rajiv, so I have never done one of these before, but I feel I'm in such august and amazing company. All you guys are such lovely actors. It's a big honor for me to be on this platform with all of you, except you, Rajiv, who I think is a pretty bad actor.
pretty bad actor.
But yeah, wow. It's great.
Thank you. Jaydeep, Pradeep, do you want to add to that?
सर मुझे लगता है दोनों ही मुश्किल है और दोनों ही बहुत आसान है. डिपेंड करता है किस दिन आपका सुर सही लग जाता है. किसी किसी दिन आपको बिल्कुल रोना नहीं आता है, आप कुछ कर लो ना हंसना आता है. ऐसे फंसते हो आप, एक नॉर्मल स्माइल, एक नॉर्मल यॉनिंग, एक नॉर्मल पलक झपकाना आपसे नहीं हो पाता. किसी दिन इतना मुश्किल सीन होता है और आपका सुर लग जाता है, इजिली हो जाता है. तो डिपेंड करता है कि उस दिन आपका. पर मैं पर्सनली मेरे लिए एकदम मुक्का फाड़ के जो हंसना होता है ना बहुत दिल से, वो थोड़ा मुश्किल होता है. क्योंकि वो बहुत जल्दी नकली दिख सकता है या हो सकता है. वो फील लेवल बहुत मुश्किल है. वो राज वाली बात है कि उसको बिलीवेबल बनाना ना, कि इतना बिलीवेबल आदमी को लगे कि जैसे सर सैफ सर कह रहे थे पीछे खड़े हुए आदमी को देखना कि यार वो आदमी ही इज जस्ट हैविंग यू नो गुड टाइम बेसिकली. और लोग उसका, लोगों का ध्यान जाए, इतना बिलीवेबल बनाना उसको, वो थोड़ा सा मुश्किल है. अदरवाइज निकल जाता है.
एक एक्टर होता है ना सर, वो किरदारों को जो कैरेक्टर प्ले करता है ना, तो उसके दुख को ले लेता है अपने साथ और अपनी खुशी उसको दे देता है, तो ये बड़ा कठिन काम है।
क्या बात है।
हाँ हाँ, हम अपनी हैप्पीनेस हमेशा करेक्ट,
बहुत सही बात है, करेक्ट,
उसका उसका जो पेन है ना वो लेके हम गाड़ी में बैठ जाते हैं।
So I would agree with Jaideep sir that both are difficult and both are equally enjoyable. But I'll just tell you the example. I mean, one anecdote of my theater time, where one guy had to crack a joke and I had to laugh. और जैसे कुणाल ने बताया कि वो सामने वाले ने क्यों इतना खराब दिया, तो वो natural हंसी आई नहीं, तो मुझे जिस सुर पे हंसना था मैं उतना हंस नहीं पाया और उसके आगे का पूरा नाटक हिल गया, क्योंकि मैं अगर उतना हंसता नहीं आगे वाले को उतना क्यों नहीं मिला। And then everybody started blaming me, and I said, "But joke, कितना खराब टाइमिंग के साथ डिलीवर हुआ। How would I laugh? Because audience में भी लोग मारते मुझे कि ऐसा कौन है, ऐसा तो इसने बोला ही नहीं कि तुम इतना हंसे। But so this becomes very difficult when you actually try to react organically.
So I finally have a question that Pankaj ji has to answer. He can't say first. No, but this one he has to give his own answer. Chalo. You know, I want to ask you, in each of your respective films or your shows, what was the one scene that you were really looking forward to shooting when you read the script? And did it live up to what you had built it to be in your head? Pankaj ji, aap jayenge?
Pankaj ji, yeah.
Mujhe aap...
Saif, you're mute.
No, I'm on mute. Nahin. Nahin,
I'm saying Pankaj ji answer first.
Yeah. Mujhe yaad nahi aa raha abhi, turant bata paana. Kya tha sawal? Mere ko aam taur pe na, haan, yaad aa gaya mujhe. कि मतलब वो सीन नहीं याद आया, आपका सवाल याद आ गया, आपने क्या पूछा था मैं भूल जाऊँ जल्दी, तो जब जिस दिन लाइनें बहुत होना, पता चला कि मुझे अकेले एक पेज बोलना है और मेरा को एक्टर तीन दो लाइन बोल रहा है, हाँ हाँ आप सही बोल रहे हैं, तो मेरे को बहुत प्रेशर बढ़ जाता है यार, इतनी लाइनें बोलनी है, मैं कम चाहता हूँ बोलना, तो मैं जाते पहले राइटर डायरेक्टर को मिल के बोलता हूँ, सर अगर ये बात 15 लाइन की बजाय अगर हम लोग 6 लाइन में कर लें तो क्या दिक्कत है। मैं सा कन्विंस कुछ करके डायरेक्टर से लाइन ली जाए थोड़ी सी, कई बार ज्यादा होती भी है बिना मतलब की, तो कि याद करना बड़ा मुश्किल काम है मेरे लिए, अगर कोई डायरेक्टर ने बोल दिया कि जो मैंने लिखा है वही बोलना है तुम्हें, ताकि ने से, तब तो मेरे लिए और सरदर्दी है, मैं बाप रे बाप, तो वो मुश्किल होता है मेरे लिए, बाकी कोई मैं बहुत ज्यादा प्रिपेयर्ड होकर नहीं जाता हूँ कि यार ये सीन आज जो है उसमें, मुझे हमेशा मेरा मानना है कि एक्टिंग जो है वो रेसलिंग नहीं है, हम पछाड़ने नहीं जाते हैं किसी को, अगर हम तीन एक्टर मिलते हैं तो हम सब साथ मिलके कम्युनिकेट करना, न कि मेरा पर्पस है कि मैं और राज रेसलिंग कर रहे थे पिक्चर में, नहीं, हम दोनों मिलके सीन को बना रहे थे ताकि वो सुंदर तरीके से लोगों तक पहुंच जाए, बट एक आम धारणा है, लोग बातें करते हैं कि वो उसको खा गया, उसने उसको पछाड़ दिया, लोगों की बातें हैं, अभिनेता तो मेरे लिए कठिन मतलब प्रिपरेशन नहीं होती है और मेरे लाइनों से डर लगता है और मैं सेट पे जाकर तय करता हूँ, मुझे लगता है पहले क्या तय करना, जब तक मुझे पता नहीं चलेगा कमरे में उस लोकेशन पे खिड़की कितनी है तब तक मैं सीन नहीं तैयार कर सकता हूँ, मैं उस कमरे को देखूंगा खिड़की दिखेगी, खिड़की के बाहर क्या दिख रही है वो भी मेरे लिए कई बार फैक्टर हो जाता है कि उसको कैसे इग्नोर करूं, बहुत सुंदर कुछ है, तो खैर पूरा ऑर्गेनिक मामला है, कोई तैयारी नहीं।
Raj, did you have a scene? Did you have a specific scene in Ludo that you were really looking forward to?
Honestly, with Dada, of course, I had the story with me. I had the screenplay with me. But dialogues were something which we were given like sometimes, you know, on the same day. So that first, my introduction scene where he's reciting those, you know, food items.
Yeah.
So when he came and said that we're shooting for half an hour, I was damn scared. Because like just like Pankaj ji, I don't memorize my lines. I never learned my lines. I go through them and then I feel like, you know, I got it. I got the context. And then unless, of course, Gulzar saab ne aise kuch line likhi hai ki bolni hai, aapko uska har word ka meaning hai. Otherwise, I understand the context and I just do it my way. But that was something which I had to memorize. And I was pretty scared, you know. And then I told Dada, let's do it in Mithunda style and I'm going to dance also. So this was happening before I went to shoot that scene. And when I went there, I tried and he wanted it in like one take. It was pretty tough, but then somehow we got it. And then I think the whole film actually, in a way, you know, we were all pretty nervous that it was a very thin line to make that character human you know, loud OTT, but still human, so that people understand his emotion, that he's a lovable guy. He's not doing buffoonery here. Correct. He means what he does, though he, of course, he's madly in love. He's a little over the top, but his emotions are pure. So I think that was a very thin line for us to either go on the buffoonery side or still keep it human.
But it's such a superb scene, Raj. Do you still remember it? Do you still remember the lines?
It's very tough. I just remember maage dal tadka lage chole kulcha nimbu paage koi shak, that's it. Nothing more than that.
Pratik, I mean, that show is made up of some great scenes. What is the one that you were really looking forward to?
Nothing in particular that way, but I was intrigued by the character itself. So for me, each and every scene, each and every line, each and every instances which were created in this show was very, very, very personal and very intriguing that way. And the way we were actually, you know, exploring the entire character and its journey was very interesting for me. Because first of all, I was doing it for the first time I was working for the first time with Hansel sir. This was my first experience of mainstream OTT platform show. So that way, a lot of things happening for me for the first time. तो एक तो वो बहुत बड़ा एक दिमाग में था कि यार मैं पहली बार कुछ करने वाला हूँ इतने बड़े प्लेटफॉर्म पे कर रहा हूँ और दूसरा कि कैरेक्टर इतना इंटरेस्टिंग था बिकॉज फॉर मी इट वाज नेवर अ हीरो और अ विलन द जॉब फॉर मी वाज टू जस्ट मेक ह्यूमन आउट ऑफ इट जस्ट क्रिएट यू नो मेक इज आई मीन ह्यूमनाइज द कैरेक्टर एंड परफॉर्म एवरीथिंग बिलीवेबली एज इफ ही इज राइट इन हिज माइंड तो एक एक सीन बहुत इंटरेस्टिंग था बट द वन सीन दैट आई लव द मोस्ट आफ्टर आई shot it was the scene which happened in the last episode where Harshad, Bhushan and Ashwin bhai, they confront each other. Right. That confrontation was really interesting because sabke dimag mein the other person is villain and they are hero.
And it's also the first time you really see Harshad explode in the manner that he does. Right? It's a real betrayal. Yeah.
He raises his hand for the first time.
Correct. Seth?
Certain films have kind of what you call the item scene, you know.
Right.
So when you read it, you know that this has been written like that, it's designed like that. So it's playing to the back of the gallery and it's like, it's prepared that way. So there are certain scenes. I'm trying to think of an example of where you've been disappointed or you've thought it's different. And there have been adjustments with some directors who've said, okay, let's do this differently to what we thought. And I think that's the tricky thing sometimes when you have to, readdress your prep, you know, like you're all prepared to go one way and then you have to go another way slightly, and that can be frightening, I think, at least for me. But normally, you know, you've talked about it and you're kind of on the same page. And of course, yeah, when you read a script, you kind of say, okay, this is the big one or this is the big one, and this is going to be fun. And I think that's why I love my job so much, is because despite the awful traffic and you know, whatever the pains might be, you go to sleep thinking tomorrow's that scene. Yay, you know, and that's as simple as that, really.
Right. Nothing comes to mind immediately, huh?
About which scenes I enjoyed?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, when I signed Tanaji, it was Ajay's production and Om is a lovely guy. We spoke about it. We had that meeting. And I said, listen, I get the role. I've understood. But let's alter it. Let's give me like four item scenes, you know, as the character, and I'll do it. So he came back to me and he said, I think I've given you 10. So I said, oh, that's great. And they were all item scenes. They were, and we built them together on the set. He's a lovely director and gives you a lot of time to kind of prepare, you know, the body language of it and to perform it in a very, like I said, I thought for me, it's like the most theatrical thing I've done. You know, muttering your lines and kind of underplaying slightly is relatively simpler, I would have thought. This is, you know, you're acting with every, and for me, that was new. So he helped a lot. And I think my favorite improvisation and enjoyable scene in that was when Tanaji is escaped and my character is really upset he's escaped. And I'm sitting there drumming my thumbs on the throne and I get up and I've got four people hanging by a rope and I'm going to execute them. And the guard says, don't execute them, please, they're loyal men. And I'm waiting and I get some good news. And in my happiness, I throw my hanky in the air and the hangman hangs these guys. Yeah. And I turn around and say, sorry. So finding a bit of humor to the character was yeah. our idea, and it worked because you know people laugh in the theater and they say, "Ah, oh, that's a nice touch." So it was a rather dark scene when we were on set, but adding this bit made it a bit fun. So that's one example I could think of.
You know, Rajiv, I feel anticipation is a very dangerous thing sometimes when you're an actor, because often what happens is you start romanticizing and you think that this is the scene, and it's played 10,000 times in your head before you've actually gone and seen it. And never will it live up to how you'd imagined it. So what I personally like to do is if I see that highlight scene, then I put it away. And I don't want to look at it because I'm like, isko padhte nahi hai. And I can say in company of these guys, because you know what Raj said. And I think that's where, you know, when writers write dialogues, there is a different meter in which he's thought it. And there is a different meter when an actor comes on board. So mugging up lines is the worst thing that you can do for that character. Because the moment it looks like you're trying to say something that you don't mean and it's not coming from this character, it's going to be really bad. So for me, what I want to come at is, for example, in Loot Case, there is this Sadio Purana done by scene when the protagonist finds the money. And when he's alone, how will he react to, you know, opening that bag? And
in the neighbor's flat.
No. When he's alone with that suitcase and he opens it for the first time, you know, devoid of all the attention. And there were like five different ways that it was written because nobody was sure. One was like, he'll speak to him like a friend. One was, should it be like a romantic scene and all of that. And so much discussion happened about it that none of it actually made sense. So when we went there and after a point, we said, we'll not talk about this. So we went on set and I think even the director was like, I don't know which one is right. So we just went there and what stood out, and that's why it made it to the trailer, because it's an inconsequential scene. It's not a highlight scene in that thing, was when I opened it and I put myself in that place like him, I cried because I was like, this man has never seen so much money. So when he sees that 2000 ka thing, his immediate thing is he cries. And Rajesh was like, because I remember the making, he was like, is he crying? Why is he crying? He's supposed to be happy. Why is he crying? And it just went like that. And there was no anticipation, no preparation. But I think in the whole film, I was at least the proudest of that moment, because that moment just happened and it was never planned. So sometimes, like I said, anticipation can be a dangerous thing.
And it's a great scene, yeah. Namaz bhai?
एक्चुअली जनरली अगर मैं बताऊं, मैं बहुत सारे सीक्वेंस ऐसे होते हैं फिल्म में जो मैं सोचता हूं शायद ये ऑडियंस को क्लिक करेगा और ऑडियंस इस पे, बट वो कहीं पे भी ऑडियंस का ध्यान जाता है नहीं उन सीन्स पे. तो कभी कभी मुझे लगता है कि शायद मैं गलत हूं या सिचुएशन ऐसी थी कि वो मैंने तो ट्राई किया था पूरा मतलब टच करने का उस चीज को, बट वो ऑडियंस ने कहीं से भी, ऑडियंस के सामने तो बिल्कुल ही ऐसे ही निकल गया, फ्लैट ही निकल गया वो, बट मैंने तो ऑनेस्टी का पूरा झंडा गाड़ दिया था वहां पे टाइम पे. इस तरह का कभी कभी होता है एक्चुअली. बहुत सारे सीक्वेंस हैं. आई थिंक ये मेरी या इंडिविजुअल एक्टर की लाइकिंग डिसलाइकिंग पे बहुत डिपेंड करता है कि मैं किस तरह के सीन्स को लाइक करता हूँ, ऑडियंस किस तरह के सीन को लाइक कर रही है. कभी कभी फॉर एग्जांपल जो बुलशिट सीन होते हैं जिनको मैं बिल्कुल भी लाइक नहीं करता, और थिएटर में लोग उस पर क्लैपिंग कर रहे हैं, वाह वाह कर रहे हैं, ये वो सब इस तरह की चीज हो रही है, जो पर्सनली मैं लाइक ही नहीं करता उन सीन्स को, और जो मैं लाइक करता हूँ वो फ्लैट निकल जाते हैं, पता ही नहीं चलता. बहुत सारे बहुत आचार्य के साथ बैठ के अपनी लाइफ के बारे में बता रहा हूँ, अपनी जर्नी के बारे में बता रहा हूँ, मैं ट्राई कर रहा था यार इसमें, और मैंने कई फिल्मों में ट्राई किया बट वो पल्ले ही नहीं पड़ा किसी के, बट मैं मुझे लगता है कि शायद मैं गलत था यार, मेरी कुछ मेरा मैं रॉन्ग ट्रैक पे जा रहा हूँ. तो उसमें मैंने उसको ड्राई रखा, कहीं से भी थोड़ा सा भी इमोशनल नहीं होने दूंगा इसको, क्योंकि इमोशंस बहुत इजीली आ जाता है. ये सबसे बड़ी प्रॉब्लम ये है कि मे बी शायद वो कैरेक्टर का इमोशन नहीं, वो तेरा खुद का इमोशन है, उसको कैरेक्टर में घुसड़ने की कोशिश मत कर. बट सीन में मैंने ये गलतियां की कि मेरा जो पर्सनल फ्रस्ट्रेशन था या पर्सनल जो मेरा इमोशन था किसी वजह से, मेरी पर्सनल लाइफ की वजह से, व्हाटएवर जो भी होता है हर आदमी की लाइफ में होता, तो मैंने सीन में घुसड़ने की कोशिश की और वहीं पे मतलब फेलियर हो गया मैं, क्योंकि वो कैरेक्टर के इमोशन था ही नहीं एक्चुअली. कई बार हुआ ऐसा.
जयदीप, हाथीराम चौधरी हैड सम इनक्रेडिबल सीन्स.
जी,
सुपर बेटा.
थैंक यू.
व्हाट वाज द सीन यू वर मोस्ट लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड?
ग्रेटली रिटन बाय सुदीप सर एंड द टीम, बिकॉज़ आधा काम हो जाता है अगर स्क्रिप्ट और लाइनें बहुत अच्छी लिखी हो. जैसे ना सबने बोली है बात के राजी एक ऐसी फिल्म थी, जैसे गुलजार राज कह रहा था कि गुलजार साहब ने लाइनें लिखी वो तो आपको समझ में आता है, तो वो राजी एक ऐसी फिल्म थी जहां हर लाइन हर शब्द काकू के की भी एग्जैक्टली वैसे ही बोले गए थे जो स्क्रिप्ट पे थे. आई थिंक बिकॉज ऑफ द इकोनॉमी ऑफ वर्ड्स वाज सो इम्पोर्टेंट कि उस दौर में इतने लोग जो वैसे ही बहुत कम बोलता है किरदार, बट पारलोक में उस तरह का नहीं था. एक लंबी लाइनें होती थी या बहुत कुछ मोनोलॉग थे. जैसे दो सीन्स का मैं जिक्र करूंगा जो जब पहली बार हाथीराम और अंसारी बस स्टैंड पे बैठे और अंसारी पूछता है कि सर आपका कुछ चल रहा है विर्क के साथ. आई थिंक जब मैंने पढ़ा था वो सीन मुझे पहली बार लगा था कि यहाँ पहला ये पहला मौका है जहां ऑडियंस या मैं भी पढ़ते वक्त मुझे पहली बार पता चलता है कि हाथीराम किस तरह का इंसान है या उसकी पिछली जिंदगी किस तरह की रही है. तो वहां से एक स्टार्ट मिलेगा जो सबको मिलेगा. और जो जिस सीन का मैं जिक्र कर रहा हूँ वो द लास्ट सीन जब वो मेहरा के ऑफिस में जाता है टूटा फूटा सा है लास्ट पिछली रात को बस बच के वापस आया है. और मुझे याद है मेकअप वेकअप करके खड़े थे और सुदीप सर कह रहे थे कि यार जयदीप कोई बाय करेगा इस बात को, कोई मानेगा कि एक कुत्ते की वजह से इतनी बड़ी घटना खत्म हो गई, मरा नहीं कोई. मैंने कहा सर अगर महाभारत में लिखा हुआ है और मान लेते हैं तो ये भी मान ही लेंगे लोग, डिपेंड करता है हम कहते कैसे हैं. आप एक बार देखो एक ट्राई करके देखते हैं, रिहर्सल करके देखते हैं, और अगर आपको लगे कि वो जो तरीका है हाथीराम के बताने का कि मैं इस आदमी को एक कहानी सुनाने जा रहा हूं अभी महाभारत का किस्सा उठा के बात कुछ और कहना चाह रहा है, फेल्ट लाइक टेरेंटिनो काइंड ऑफ फिल्म के मर्डर करने जा रहे हैं और बर्गर के बारे में बात हो रही है, वैसा वाला फील आ रहा था. तो वो जिस तरह से वो लाइनें जितनी खूबसूरती से लिखी हुई थी ना उनको याद करने की जरूरत नहीं थी, हम सब ने महाभारत पढ़ी है. तो वो बस बैठ के हाथीराम अपना किस्सा बता रहा था उसको कि मैं बताता हूँ तुम्हारी लाइफ में क्या चला है. वो बहुत बहुत मजा आया उसको करते वक्त, और वो एक सीन था जो मुझे लगा कि एक बार देखूंगा इसका रिस्पॉन्स क्या आएगा, किस तरह से बाहर निकल के आता है. तो होता है कभी कभी किसी किसी सीन में, बट लाइनें याद करना थोड़ा सा भारी हो जाता है क्योंकि मुझे लगता है कि बंद जाएगा एक्टर अगर आप वर्ड टू वर्ड याद करके घर से जाना शुरू करोगे. अगर किसी एक्टर ने ऊपर नीचे कुछ कर दिया तो आप फंस जाओगे.
Listen, can I ask a question? A very interesting thing has come up. How many of you guys like change your lines on sets? And how often does that happen? Because I like used to get in trouble. Like I remember Farhan, like you try and change. I there's written something. Arey main to am ar ye. So I said, arey main to au something. He said, have I written au? I said, no. He said, what have I written? I said, am ar. He said, then say am ar. So humko aise sikhaya ki can't change a line with some of these guys. You guys make up your own lines.
That depends, sir. That depends. I think just
let's go around. Start with Rajiv. Ask the question to these guys. I want to know.
Do you change your lines? We've got a great question from Sir.
I think yes, you do improvise your lines. Does. But I definitely believe that it's very important to give the written line the due respect. Because वो obviously एक writer ने एक 6 महीना 8 महीना एक साल लेके वो लाइनों को लिखा है. उसको सिर्फ ये कह के कहना कि because I'm not feeling comfortable right now बोलते हुए I think it's not fair on the writer. Okay. Yes, it's not your job to be comfortable. No, your job is to go out there and perform the scene how it's been written. So to give that due importance is important.
Go on. Who's next?
But sir, कई बार ऐसा होता है कभी कभी किसी किसी प्रोजेक्ट में बहुत गंदी लाइनें लिखी होती है. इतनी गंदी लाइनें लिखी होती है तो आपको लगता है जैसे देवेंदु भाई कह रहे थे डेफिनेटली वो रिस्पेक्ट मिलनी चाहिए कि एक राइटर ने उस पर वक्त लगाया है. बट अगर वो खराब है ना तो फिर वो पंकज भाई वाला है कि 15 लाइनों को सीधा 6 पे ले आओ और उनमें बिलीव ढूंढने की कोशिश करो कि इन 6 में बेस्ट क्या हो सकता है. बट जैसे राजी थी एक शब्द को इधर से उधर करने की जरूरत नहीं पड़ी बिकॉज दे वर रिटन सो ब्यूटीफुली. एक वर्ड का ऐसा मतलब निकलता था तो जरूरत ही नहीं पड़ी, बिल्कुल जरूरत नहीं पड़ी.
उसमें क्या है ना सर, कोई आमतौर पे हमारे बहुत सारे राइटर टीवी मीडियम से आए हैं सिनेमा में.
करेक्ट.
डेली सोप का राइटर जो संवाद लिखता है ना तो उसकी ट्रेनिंग कि 2.5 मिनट के सीन को 7 मिनट लिखना.
Oh my God! But how interesting! How interesting!
वो अब मुझे याद है मैं एक डेली सोप कर रहा था बहुत साल पहले सर, और एक सीन था संस्कार के ऊपर. मैं संस्कार की बात किसी कैरेक्टर को बोलता हूँ कि तुम संस्कारों की बात करते हो. 5 लाइन में करीबन 12 जगह संस्कार शब्द का इस्तेमाल था. मैं बोला यार ये 12 क्यों कर रहे हो, दो ही तीन जगह में काम कर लेते हैं ना। तो अगर लाइनें कमाल लिखी हो, अगर हमारे वो आपको समझ है कि लाइन बहुत ग्रेट है तो बिल्कुल छेड़ने की जरूरत नहीं है।
कभी कभी करना पड़ता है।
जैसे एक बार क्या हुआ, एक डायरेक्टर ने मुझे बोला एज इट इज बोलो, आप आपकी जगह हाँ ही बोलो ना, और ऐसे पूरा एज इट इज बोलो। तो वो माबे उसने बोला कि देखो लाइंस जो होती ना गीता की तरह होती है, यू नो जो लिखा हुआ है वो गीता की तरह वही बोलना पड़ेगा। और क्योंकि अल पचिनो जो है बिल्कुल एग्जैक्ट वही लाइनें बोलता है। मैंने डिनेरो तो कुछ और बोलता है, डिनेरो बोले जहां आपको दो पन्नों की जरूरत है, अगर एक एक आई बोल से वो बात कह सकते हैं तो दो पेजेस की जरूरत नहीं, हटा दो उसको यार, क्यों बोल रहे हो खामखा। जैसे वो पंकज भी बता रहा था अभी कि क्या अगर दो लाइन में वो बात क्लियर हो रही तो काहे का एक पेज या दो पेज लिखने की जरूरत है।
बिल्कुल, आई थिंक इट टोटली डिपेंड्स ऑन योर डायरेक्टर। इफ योर डायरेक्टर इज वेरी कीन कि आप एग्जैक्टली वही बोलो, आप यू कैन डिस्कस विद हिम him or her ke yaar listen I'm not feeling too comfortable, but in, I think eventually it's the director's call. So you can't really fight.
But how often do you do it, Raj?
I do tend to change my lines. I actually improvise. I don't change my lines. I tend to improvise a lot, and luckily the directors I've worked with till date are very open about the idea of improvising, and I think and things have become better by improvising. Of course there have been moments where you know it must have not fired work the right way. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, but I'm saying like a very small example. अगर किसी ने लिखा है मैंने खून किया है, and in the take if I say खून मैंने किया है, तो I don't want somebody to come say नहीं नहीं इसमें तो मैंने खून किया है लिखा है।
अच्छा नहीं ऐसे भी है director जो बोलते नहीं,
but meaning is same. Yeah, so sometimes like अरे but खून मैंने किया या मैंने खून किया, it's the same thing. Why are you so worried कि वो मैंने
as long as you're not saying as long as you're not saying खून मैंने नहीं किया है.
You know, I think it also comes down to not that we are anybody to judge anybody's caliber, but you see that on the paper. But like it's a good example what Raj just said. But you know, if for example a director or a writer can back it up by saying that you know in performance it's maine pause khun kiya hai, then you can understand that ki acha theek hai fir ye aisa theek hai. Unnecessarily maine idhar bolo ya udhar bolo mein farak ho jata hai. So that's why I think what he's right. I mean all of us are saying that we improvise. I don't think anybody is saying that ki yaar tune ye kya ghatiya line likhi hai change hi kar de, unless you're stuck in that situation where somebody is there. But then there have been times where somebody writes lines so beautifully and to the meter. I've worked with some writers who actually dialogue writers who perform the scene, so they know the meter bang on. And even if you want to, you can't do anything with them because they just stick like that. Other situation is if you get stuck and you're not able to say a word. Like there are actors who sometimes, you know, they're not able to give the correct pronunciation. In that case, then it's a different story. You'll have to change the word because you won't be able to say it.
Yeah.
I think my formula is either you convince me or get convinced.
Correct. Yeah.
So that's how it works. That's how it works. But in most of the cases, sir, just wanted to add one thing that if the lines are so poetic that we can't change it, we don't change it. But there are certain lines which are so descriptive, like just Pankaj ji said, ke wo pura sanskar pe agar bhashan dena hai, waisa agar pura hai, then the gist of it should be communicated.
Yeah.
Not in terms of number of the screen time or the kitna line main bol raha hu.
Matlab tum Shakespeare most... ko nahi bologe ki what is this to be or not to be.
You can't. I guess.
Yeah. Look.
And most of the writers are writing names when two guys are talking in a husband and wife conversation. Neeta, tum samajh nahi rahi ho, Neeta. But how many times do you call your wife by her name when you are sitting together? So when writer writes, they have something in mind. So there is something I call it a transmission loss. For writers, pages to director's brain and from director's brain to actor's brain. That transmission loss, if we can minimize it as an actor, then we are bang on. Or else we need to change a lot of things.
Right, I agree.
Mena, I always get that confused with this thing. Ke, acha, agar usko keh raha hai ki Neeta, tum baat nahi samajhti. Neeta, meri baat to samjho, Neeta. To agar aapko lag raha hai ki ye itni baar Neeta bolne ki zarurat nahi hai, bol diya. But the whole point where I get confused is ke ye character bolta hai Neeta.
Ye then it has to be continuous, right?
Then,
I agree.
How would you justify that?
It can be individual scene. The point is, it can be individual scene. Then it has to be throughout.
then it is okay.
Yeah,
it's a character.
Consistency has to
then
be
it's
there,
a consistent.
Yeah.
Because there are a lot of places what happens is ki is scene ka reference alag film hai, is scene ka reference alag film hai.
Yeah.
But we are making one film. We are not making multiple films. So then suddenly the actor will look dumb. Ki ye kya kiya yaar, ek scene mein to aisa tha, is scene mein aisa kyun hai?
So the feeling I'm getting is that depending on the quality of the writing, sometimes you feel as an actor, oh, I think I can do this better than it's written. You guys are so experienced. And sometimes we get bad stuff that's not been thought properly by a writer. But sometimes we get good stuff that's really written carefully and that we are true to. And the stuff we have to wing, sometimes we have to wing.
Correct.
Yeah.
And again, that's why it's important to always have a dialogue with them.
Sorry, Raj.
Yeah. I'm saying if the lines are great, of course, none of us, if the lines are great, none of us would think of changing them.
Yeah,
we want good lines. Nobody would say, I want bad dialogues so I can change them. We all want, you know, good writing.
Yeah. But the art of survival, the survival story of every artist is something more than just what's on screen. Na? Sometimes you have to fight and fix yourself.
But abhi kya? अभी दुनिया में वो दौर है ना कि राइटर जो होता है ना अगर सेट पे रहेगा तो बोलेगा मेरा ठीक तेरे ठीक से ज्यादा ठीक है.
No, but some writers are flexible on set also. They like
very, very flexible. Yeah.
It's nice to have a writer on set.
Yeah. Yeah.
बट यू नो मैम मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम मैंने देखा क्योंकि हमारा सिनेमा बहुत ही वर्बोस है अगर देखा जाए. आई एम सॉरी टू से बट हम लोग बहुत बोलते हैं, हम लोग अंडरलाइन करते हैं हर चीज को. ये बहुत है हमारे यहाँ, कभी भी पॉजेस लिखे ही नहीं जाते. ये एक्टर को कभी कभी, आई एम सॉरी, कुछ राइटर्स को छोड़ के मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम जो एक्टर खुद ही डिसाइड कर देते यहाँ पे यार पॉज बनता है यहाँ तो पॉज, क्योंकि टॉपिक चेंज हो रहा है, सब्जेक्ट चेंज हो रहा है, तो बेटर है कि यहाँ पे पॉज बनता है. हम लोग ने साइलेंस लिखना नहीं शुरू किया एक्चुअली, क्योंकि हम लोगों की जो ट्रेडिशनली जो हमने शुरू किया वो ट्रेडिशनल जो प्लेस थे, नाटक होते थे, जो उनसे शुरू किया. तो इवन मैंने भी एक बहुत बार गलती की थी कि मैं साइकिल पे, एक सीन था कि साइकिल लेके खड़ा हूं मैं एक लड़की को बोलता हूँ, सीन में था ये, क्या जो मेरी साइकिल पे बैठ जा, लेके चलता हूँ तुझे घुमाने. तो डायरेक्टर ने, समझदार डायरेक्टर थे, मैं बता रहा हूँ, इरफान भाई थे एक्चुअली, इरफान भाई डायरेक्ट कर रहे थे, तो उन्होंने बोला यार साइकिल तो दिख ही रही है, फिर साइकिल क्यों बोल रहा है. मीडियम विजुअल, ऑडियो विजुअल मीडियम है, विजुअल भी है यार. तो हम लोग पता है अंडरलाइन, हर चीज को अंडरलाइन कर करके बोलते हैं, रो भी रहे हैं, डायलॉग भी बोल रहे हैं, हर चीज का मतलब बर्बोस तो बहुत है. आई एम सॉरी टू से,
बट आप सही कह रहे हैं, वो शायद कहीं ना कहीं कल्चर में है कि राजा पधार रहे हैं, ये राजा वो है, ये
पधार भी रहे, बोल भी रहे,
इंट्रोडक्शन एंड यू नो बोल भी रहे हैं, वी लाइक दिस ट्रेडिशन. तो डिपेंड करता है कि वो किरदार कैसा है. वो हो सकता है बहुत ही ज्यादा वर्बोस और उस मतलब उसको हर बात बतानी है तुम्हें, वो चलते चलते
आप
मैं तो पूछ लेता हूँ कभी कभी डायरेक्ट राइटर से कि आप लोगों ने बहुत सारा ध्यान दिया इस पे, आपने मेहनत की है ना, तो वी कैन ट्राई एंड मेक दिस वर्क. डू वी मेक दिस वर्क और डू वी मेक इट बेटर? आई गेस टू डिफरेंट.
बट डू दे एवर से कि नहीं नहीं हमने मेहनत नहीं किया? ऑफ कोर्स दे विल ऑलवेज
नहीं नहीं हम तो अभी सुबह पैसे मिले, अभी आगे लिखे.
आपको जो बोलना है बोल दीजिए.
बट जनरली लाइक जैसे वन स्मॉल थिंग, आई हैड दिस वन सीन इन माय फर्स्ट फिल्म प्यार का पंचनामा, द ओपनिंग सीन वेयर लिक्विड कम्स होम और ये घंटी बजा रहा है, दोस्त वीडियो गेम खेल रहे हैं एंड ही रियली हैज टू पी और वो दरवाजा नहीं खोल रहे, उन्हें कैसे ना करके दरवाजा खोलता है और ये पहले उनको एक छोटा मोनोलॉग लेता है, सालो तुम मर जाओ, तुम्हें पता नहीं है अभी गड्ढे से निकला मेरा निकल जाता और ये वो बोलता है. तो मैं लव रंजन से हमेशा ही पूछता था कि अगर इतना जोर से लगी है तो क्या पहले बात करेगा या पहले करने जाएगा? अभी तो हम ये एस्टैब्लिश कर रहे थे कि इसकी जान जा रही है. अभी नाउ व्हेन ही ओपन्स द डोर ही फील्स द नीड कि मैं पहले पूरा तुझे मोनोलॉग सुनाऊंगा और तब मैं जाऊंगा. एंड दैट्स व्हाट ही सेड कि नो दिस कैरेक्टर वुड डू दिस. We are not talking about you, Divyendu, as a sensible person. Let me go pee first and then I'll come and bajao you. No, he is like this. He is that anal emotionally that he would come first, say things to you, then he would go and pee.
But the natural thing
both ways, I mean,
but that's great.
But वो तो natural thing है ना कि अगर आ रही है तो Divyendu को हो चाहे मुझे पंकज को आ रही तो आ रही है.
तो यही
where is the character actually? वो तो natural चीज़ है यार वो.
मैं बोल रहा हूँ कि आज राजीव जी अगर कार्यक्रम शुरू करके चले जाते तो भी हम लोग संभाल लेते पूरे।
बढ़िया जा रहा है। But I want to just go back to ask Divendu that question because we missed and that question really I specifically want to ask you, Divendu, was there a scene that you were really looking forward to? And I wonder if it is Munna Tripathi's death scene, because that is such a big moment in that last season of Mirzapur. What was it like actually shooting that scene? And, you know, because it really is the culmination of two seasons, the culmination of a character that people have begun to really enjoy. What was it like shooting that scene?
You die in the second season.
It was very painful to do that scene, not in terms of character emotion. It was so painful to shoot that scene because it was so bloody hot. And Pankaj also was there. And हमको याद है हमारी आंखें नहीं खुल रही थी. And it was actually, I was like, मैं ना भगवान सच में मर जाऊँ, ये ना scene जल्दी खत्म हो, बहुत हो गया. Because I was like, listen, I have done season one, season two, अब ये मर रहा है, यहाँ अभी तक या तो लोग मुझे पसंद कर चुके हैं या मुझे पसंद नहीं कर रहे. ऐसा नहीं होगा कि अभी तक पसंद नहीं किया और वो कहेंगे वो जो एक सीन दिया था ना वो दोनों सीजन पे हावी पड़ गया. ऐसा नहीं होगा. बट इट वाज आई एक्सपेक्टेड इट टू बी अ मच मोर टू बी ऑनेस्ट. एंड आई लव माय मेकर्स बट आई वाज एक्सपेक्टिंग मच मोर आउट ऑफ दैट सीन. मुझे लगा वो काफी धुप्पल में निकल गया, यू नो, वो मतलब थोड़ा सा ऐसे ही था. So yeah, I mean, it happens that you think that it's such an epic moment. This character is dying now, and you know there is matlab pata nahi kya ho jayega. You know, there was a lot of drama that day. Like I said, dhoop thi, uske baad barish aa gayi, everything. There was natural drama, but it was okay for me, man. To be honest, it was just okay to be. I didn't think ke, this is that scene which I need. The scene I felt was in season one, killing of Compounder, my friend. Jab usko maara, that was one scene where I felt ke, how to approach it.
What about Bhosle wale uncle? I fell off my chair. That show became gold at that line. I was like, what kind of show is this? It's the funniest thing I've heard on film. And you said it so well.
But, yeah, chacha.
That was improvised. By you?
Yeah, I did.
Oh really? Wow.
Lucky boy.
You look See, like sir, improvisation helps.
Dekho, help haan aa gaya.
Yeah.
But what a so dying
best line, the best line on the show was made up by the actor.
What are dying scenes like to shoot? I mean, what are death scenes like to shoot? I'm sure you've all done it.
Who hasn't done one?
Who hasn't done a death scene?
Who hasn't done what?
Sabne kiya hai.
Everyone's done?
Sabne. I think, haan.
Haan, sabne kiya hoga.
Seth, what's it like to shoot?
I'm trying to think where I last did some death scene. I don't know.
I don't know.
They're damn difficult. Yeah, they're Amit Ji.
They are difficult.
Rajkumar or something.
You know, it's tricky because, you know, I've grown up watching Bollywood and our mind...
It's tricky because I've never died.
Yeah, no, also, but you don't know how it feels. So you get so conditioned by watching Hindi films. So whenever there used to be, when we were growing up, there'll be a bullet shot like, ah! So you know, you think, oh, maybe that's how it is. And then there's this actor, you know, Mr. Irfan Khan, he comes and then we see him dying on screen. Like Hasil. Oh my God. And he changed my whole conditioning of how people die on screen. Or be it De Niro in Taxi Driver. You know, it was just insane. It's like, no, you don't have to like be like, no, nothing. It's there. It's done. And like how Nawaz Bhai did like Manoj Sir in Vasipur also. Like these actors, they have changed my perception of how people die on screen. Like I've just shot for a film. It's also technical. Like I can't name the film, but so I had this dying scene in the film and it was raining. And the director wanted me to lie down and it's pouring. And I had to die like some 30, 40 seconds because somebody's killing me. And I can't, and it's very tough to breathe when there's water going inside your nostrils. It became so technical for me. I was like, how people do that? You know, you can't breathe in if you're standing under a shower, you can't breathe. So it was very technical that way. But yeah, dying scenes are interesting. For me, I think I've never really done too many dying scenes, but I think it's very interesting how you do that.
I also look forward to doing one good one day. It's a because I completely agree with Raj.
Omkara.
That I didn't die in Omkara. Everyone else died. I did die. She cut my
yeah.
Yes.
Was on that jhula, yeah.
That was
while coming down, yeah.
But I agree completely that we've been conditioned to think of death scenes in a certain way, and it'd be so much fun to do it differently. But I haven't grown enough yet. But I plan to. I would love to do one day, a good one.
That's why you're using Tim's iPad.
Yeah.
Nawaz bhai, do you a death scene?
I think डेथ सीन मैंने जो पहली बार मैं शॉक्ड हुआ था किसी सीन से तो वो था सत्या के मैं मनोज वाजपेयी उसको क्योंकि उससे पहले हम मरने से पहले हीरो पूरी सोलोलोकी बोल के जाता था अब कभी कभी तो ये सा ऐसा लगने लगा था यार मरना बहुत बहुत बोल अगेन वो बर्बोस वाली बात हो गई ना कि मर भी रहा है और पूरा का पूरा सोलोलोकी बोल के जानी है उसको नहीं यार मरे जल्दी मर जाए यार क्योंकि अभी पिक्चर काफी टाइम हो गया देखते देखते फर्स्ट टाइम मैं शॉक्ड हुआ था तो वो सत्या से हुआ था मैं कि जब गोली लेगी ठक खत्म चलो आगे सीन करो तो और वो दूसरा सीन चल रहा था फिल्म का लेकिन मैं अभी भी उस सीन में पहली बार चूंकि मैंने हिंदी फिल्म में हिस्ट्री में पहली बार ऐसा डेथ सीक्वेंस देखा कि मैं दूसरे सीन पिक्चर का दूसरा सीन चल रहा था लेकिन मैं उस सीन के बारे में सोच रहा था मैं दैट वाज द अमेजिंग एक्चुअली
एंड इट वाज सो सडन दैट सीन वाज सो सडन द वे रामू सर I think executed it.
Exactly.
Nothing. No drama. Damn, bachi, bachi,
no drama. Bachi, nothing. Tham. Exactly.
बाद में रामूजी बहुत ड्रामा करने लगे.
I was wondering who's going to say that. Pankaj ji, spab. Yeah, but that was a badass film. Lovely movie.
Yeah.
Yes. बाद के दिनों में रामूजी का कैमरे का एंगल और बिल्ड अप
There were so many new things about that film. I remember watching it in Jaya Talkies in Borivali. And nobody had got the sound of the bullet right till then. Because remember the moment thang happened, everybody in the theater thought kuch hua hai. Because we had not heard it in a theater, the bullet sounded very different.
Exactly.
It was just path-breaking in so many ways, actually.
That's the exciting thing.
I mean, such a nice observation that is.
Yeah.
Rajiv ji, there is a show on Criminal Justice. Aaj hi trailer aaya hai. Socha uska bhi prachar kar dun.
Bilkul.
Are you plugging your show?
No.
Yeah.
Oh, fab. Which show? Because you're too cute there. Yeah.
Criminal Justice Behind Doors कुछ नाम है इस सीजन का. एक पहले.
इसको अपने फिल्मों के और सीरीज के नाम ही याद नहीं रहते. इतने
How can you forget the name of what you're plugging?
No, not plugging. वो लोग ना बार-बार मुझे मैसेज कर रहे हैं. अब 4:20 से उनका टाइम था.
Last question. Okay. I want to end by asking all of you, what is the best piece of acting that you saw this year? It could be by a male actor, by a female actor. What is the best acting that you saw this year?
So I saw two. One was Jaydeep in Patal Lok and one was Prateek in Scam. It was brilliant.
I saw Jaydeep in Patal Lok. I thought Khemu was pretty good in Loot Case. I think Rajkumar is one of the best actors I've ever seen. I haven't seen anything this year, I don't remember. But I mean, our last thing I saw was Trapped and then Newton. They were amazing. Pankaji, I just did a movie with and I've watched Mirzapur and so much of what he's done. I've watched him Lagao a bit also. I mean, I didn't make... do all... whatever. More on that in private. Devan, you were amazing in Mirzapur. Mr. Nawaz, I don't know what he's
Mr.
doing.
Mr. Nawaz.
Making something on his desk.
Series nahi koi ki maine. Series is koi nahi ki maine, but film ki thi.
Yeah, lovely. So you're all great. And I haven't seen Prateek's show yet, sadly. But I'm really looking forward to it.
Please
Everybody
watch
I've worked
it.
With has said it's the best show in India. Everybody
but you know, I mean, we're saying what happened this year, but I mean, Bhai already said that, but I have to say that all these actors that I'm seeing in these screens, I am a diehard fan of. And I have to say, when I looked at the screen, I'm not going to say starstruck, I was talent struck. Because individually, I have seen all their works and I am in awe of all their works and I really respect each and every actor. But because you asked this year, those were the two things that just stood out.
See, that's the trick. Never answer the question, Kim.
Correct.
But you're the one who was asking people that why are you going?
I don't know. I'm just saying.
Divendu, what did you see this year that you really
saw? Not trying to being politically correct here, but I mean, seriously, enjoyed each and every performance. If I have to put a finger on one, which I don't want to, then it has to be Jaideep. I mean, Hathiram. It was very subtle, very nuanced. But seriously, it's not fair to answer this question because it's absolutely everyone here has been so brilliant with their work.
So it's like three of us who are saying Jaideep. I think we have to give him something at the end, unless guys disagree. You agree also, Pratik?
Yes, absolutely.
And Raj?
I agree totally. See, the thing is, Pankaji, I've seen...
Pankaji, it's almost done. What? Jaideep, you win.
मैंने scam देखा. I think मैंने. I'm sorry. मैंने कोई इसके अलावा कोई series नहीं देखा. जैसे scam देखा था मैंने. And he was amazing.
Yes.
For me, Rajiv sir, actually, sorry, Hanava sir, finish.
हाँ हाँ मैं ये कह रहा था कि मैंने मैंने मैं ज़्यादातर जो फिल्में देखी हैं मैंने स्पेशली अब्रॉड मतलब फॉरेन फिल्में देखी मैंने ज़्यादातर इस लॉकडाउन के दौरान आई थिंक 150-200 फिल्में और एक सीरीज देखी बस स्कैम एंड ही वाज अमेजिंग
बट नवाज भाई प्लीज देखना मिर्जापुर और
मैं जरूर देखूंगा
बता लो
बहुत जरूरी है
बट मैंने तारीफ बहुत सुनी यार आपकी
Yeah, for me, of course, all these performances, I've seen all, like, whoever I'm seeing right now in the frame, sabka kaam dekha hai maine is saal. And they all are brilliant in it. Of course, Jaideep and Pratik, they really stand out because, you know, it's just awesome what they have done. It's outstanding with Patal Lok and Scam. But, Saif sir, before I tell my performance of the year, I want to tell you one thing. I have a friend, and that day we were just sitting and we talk about, you know, cinema and acting. And he said last decade ka top three performances we were counting. And he said Omkara, Saif Ali Khan in Omkara is the top three decade performance for him.
And nice, he's a stand the test of time. That's great.
He's an intelligent guy.
Time we did something.
Anish, of course, Divendu and Jerry.
Yes.
Anish.
Yeah.
So anyway, so my apart from I love all these guys, but the one series that I saw which totally blew me away, the performance, this series called I Know This Much Is True. And Mark Ruffalo.
Yeah, in that double roles. Yeah.
Man, he's playing these identical twin brothers. And you know, there are times when you watch a performance and you start feeling so small as an actor. So that performance did that to me.
What's the name of it, Raj?
I Know This Much Is True. It's a mini series. Please watch it. As an actor, I think all of us should watch it. It's, of course, it is like, I couldn't believe it, what he did with that part. He's so effortless, so bloody real. It's like you're watching a documentary.
Wow.
It's the same director who
and,
made...
And he's playing twins, huh? So, it's even and more mind-blowing.
It's crazy because he's not putting too much effort to make these two characters so different. It's very subtle, but still you can't say that these are the same people.
Yeah.
It's insane. So, yeah, I Know This Much Is True from the international cinema, but here, I think Jaideep and Pratik.
I'm going to start Scam today.
Pratik, you want to go?
I already casted my vote.
For Jerry, okay. Jerry, you? आपके लिए?
सर दो चीजें definitely एक जो राज ने बताया Mark Ruffalo वाला जो सीरीज है वो बहुत ही amazing है दूसरा एक इस साल मैंने Spy देखा था जो कि amazing काम था again वो भी limited series है and Sasha is next level मतलब वो अलग ही zone में है और डेफिनेटली अगर आपने हमारी बात करें सबका काम मिर्जापुर 2-1 डेफिनेटली दोनों भाई बैठे हैं हमारे यहाँ और स्कैम मुझे याद है मैंने जब कुछ देर पहले मैं और प्रतीक आपस में ही बात कर रहे थे एक शो पे तो बहुत मजा आया उसको देख के एंड आई लव्ड बंदिश बैंडिट वेरी नाइसली आई फाउंड इट वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग एंड वेरी सूदिंग यू नो द परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ एवरीवन नसीर भाई एंड ऑल द पीपल सो या
Okay.
I had so much fun watching Loot Case. Maham, हंसते गिर रहे थे उस फिल्म में. It was and this, those scenes when you were talking about Kunal sir, जो आप बात कर रहे थे ना पहली बार पैसे को देख के, not just first time, जी. The entire film, you have the relationship with that bag is so amazing when you talk to him in you know private time. It was also what's fun yeah. watching it.
Yeah, yeah, good job,
good job. You know, I want to add that Kunal has one of the best comic. Timing, I think, whatever actors I've seen in
I remember one scene. One scene in particular.
Go, God. He was amazing.
Pagalpan ho.
Insane. Yeah. Kunal. All of you guys are. Yeah.
So he
was
too
Hindi funny. English is one of
them. Hindi English is brilliant. So main mar jaun.
कितने
मीम बने आपका, अभी इतना सोचे नहीं है, अभी थोड़ा सोचेंगे.
ऐसा ही नहीं सोचे पर सोचेंगे.
पंकज जी,
थैंक यू.
मैं क्या बताऊं, मैं तो पहले मैंने दो एपिसोड हाथीराम देखा है, जयदीप का शो, और मैंने फोन भी किया था दो एपिसोड देख के, उसके बाद नहीं देखा हूं, माफी चाहता हूं. प्रतीक का नहीं देखा हूं, मेरी दूसरी है इन सब सारे लोगों से. मैं कोई भी सिनेमा कंटेंट नहीं देख पाता हूं, मेरे लिए मुश्किल. मैं किताबें पढ़ लूंगा, ये इसलिए नहीं बोल रहा हूं कि मैं इंटेलेक्चुअल साउंड होना चाहता हूं.
नहीं, इसलिए बोल रहे हो कि आप बहुत ज्यादा काम कर रहे हो, पैसे थोड़े कम कमाओ, क्या कर रहे हो.
मैंने इस पूरे इस छुट्टी में लॉकडाउन में एक मलयालम फिल्म देखी, ट्रांस करके, ट्रांस सिनेमा एक देखा
की.
और दूसरा क्या देखा हूँ, दूसरा
याद आए तो बता देना बाद में.
हाँ, खोजना पड़ेगा. यस.
कौन सी किताब, अच्छी किताब कौन सी पढ़ी फिर?
काफी कुछ पढ़ी. नए नए हिंदी के जितने राइटर्स हैं सर, यंग एज के लड़के हैं सब, उनको पढ़ा. उसमें प्रवीण कुमार हैं, डीयू में प्रोफेसर हैं, उनकी किताब अभी भी पढ़ रहा हूँ. और नीलोत्पल हैं, दिव्य प्रकाश हैं, बहुत सारे यंग राइटर्स जो हिंदी लिटरेचर में लिख रहे हैं इस वक्त, तो वो पढ़ा. बाकी टीवी सिनेमा देखने में मेरे को लगता है कहाँ, दो घंटा बैठ ही नहीं पाता हूँ, प्रॉब्लम है मेरी, तो इसलिए नहीं बोलने की स्थिति में नहीं हूँ कुछ. बट ये दोनों ग्रेट हैं, पूरा संसार बोल रहा है, तो दोनों ने दो एपिसोड देखा भी हूँ. जयदीप से तो मेरी बात भी हुई थी, उसके बाद मैंने फोन किया था उसी रात, तो बहुत ही बेहतरीन था, बहुत ही शानदार था वो.
Lockdown, happiness and so much joy and really being the escape, giving us the escape in a year that was dark. Thank you for saving us with your art. You created some incredible performances this year. These are shows and films I think that we're going to be revisiting over time. We cannot wait to see what you do next. But really, thank you for this very insightful conversation, which I feel is like a bit of a masterclass for young actors. I think that anyone who wants to become an actor would really appreciate the value of this conversation. Many, many congratulations. Thank you for the amazing work and cannot wait to see what you do next. Thank you so much.
Thanks, Rajiv. Thanks for bringing us together.
Thank you, guys.
Good idea.
Thank you.
Lots of luck and love to you all, okay? And hope
love
to see you guys soon.
To you too, sir.
Thank you so much.